H.C. Verma, Chapter 9, Question Number 19. A man of mass capital M having a bag of mass M slips from the roof of a tall building of height capital H and starts falling vertically. When at a height H from the ground, he notices there is a pond at a horizontal distance X from the line of fall. In order to save himself, he throws the bag horizontally in the direction opposite to the pond. Calculate the minimum horizontal velocity imparted to the bag so that the man lands in the water. If the man just succeeds to avoid hard ground, where will the bag land? The initial speed of the man is zero. If we assume that he takes t1 time to reach the ground, then half gt1 square must be equal to capital H. This implies t1 is equal to root under 2 into capital H divided by g. When the man throws his bag, he is at height h from the ground. This means he has fallen through a height capital H minus h. If we assume that t2 time has elapsed since the moment he slipped to the moment he threw the bag, then half gt2 square must be equal to capital H minus h. This implies t2 is equal to root under 2 into capital H minus h divided by g. So after throwing his bag, the man has t1 minus t2 time before he reaches the ground. During this time, he must travel a minimum horizontal distance of x towards right to avoid hard ground. So his minimum horizontal speed must be equal to x divided by time available, or x divided by t1 minus t2. Since when in air, no external horizontal force is acting on the man and bag system, the horizontal momentum of the system must be conserved. In other words, the magnitude of the momentum of man in horizontal direction after he throws the bag must be equal to the magnitude of momentum of the bag in horizontal direction. If we assume the horizontal speed of the bag to be v, then capital M into V0 must be equal to M into V. This implies V is equal to capital MV0 divided by M. Putting the value of V0, we get V is equal to capital M into X divided by M into T1 minus T2. Putting the value of T1 and T2, we get the speed of the bag is equal to capital M into X divided by M into root 2 capital H by G minus root under 2 into capital H minus H divided by G. Simplifying, we get V is equal to capital M into X into root G divided by M into root under 2 capital H minus root under 2 into capital H minus H. This is answer to the first part of the question. If the man was just able to avoid the hard ground, he must have traveled distance x in horizontal direction. Let us assume that the bag falls at distance y from the line of fall of man. Since there is no external horizontal force on man and bag system, the center of mass of the man and bag must remain on this line of fall. So finally, center of mass of the man and bag system is on the line of fall. Therefore, capital M into x must be equal to M into y, or y must be equal to capital M into x divided by M. This is answer to the second part of question. In order to request solution to any question from H.C. Verma book, post the question number and chapter number in comments below. Like and share the video to help other students find us. Subscribe the channel, like our Facebook page and follow us on Twitter for latest updates. Thank you for watching.